If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good nor too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster, and treat those two imposters just the same. If you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. If you can make one heap all your winnings, and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. Just like the women who fall victim to these companies, men also become manipulated by the Hunbots.
Hello, my name is Beth, or Queen of Spade, and you're watching
Manipulation of a Hunbot.
Multi-level marketing companies are known for preying on women, stay-at-home moms and army wives especially. However, there has been an epidemic of brobots, men who have been joining MLMs. It is something we don't often talk about. So, today, on this episode of The Manipulation of a Hunbot, we are going to discuss this. MLMs prey on men almost as badly as they prey on women. It is just more hidden in our society. They often prey on the fact that men want to be real men who provide well financially for their family. In today's economy, that is a much harder feat than it's been in the past. Also today, what does it actually mean to be a man? Does it mean joining a MLM company to help support your family? Many people often define being a real man by comparing it to masculinity, which are two different definitions. Masculinity is often defined as strength and or aggressiveness, while being a man is defined as an adult male. Different, yet many people put them together as one meaning. A good man is secure and confident, but not arrogant. That means he treats everyone with respect until they give him a reason not to. He knows that giving respect and agreement are not the same, and the key is to treat people with kindness, humility, and grace. It is fair to say you can define being a man any way you want, and you do not ever need a MLM company to help you do so. Direct sales has become an expansive industry with more than 100 million people now being involved in some form of direct marketing. Unlike many other large industries, men do not hold the power here. In fact, finding men's network marketing companies is a pretty difficult task. To give you an idea of the figures, only around a quarter of all direct marketers are men. At one point, the gender ratio was even more skewed, with men making up only 12% of direct marketers. Not surprisingly, women tend to be the top performers in network marketing companies as well. There have been some male-focused MLMs in the past, including Jerky Direct and Man Cave. However, Jerky Direct is no longer operational, and Man Cave no longer has an MLM component. There is something happening in the industry, though. If we take a look at the gender ratios in the U.S., the most dominant DS country, over the last few years, we find something very interesting. The percentage of men has increased from around 12% to 26%, more than doubling its share. And it isn't because fewer women are getting involved. If anything, more and more of both genders are getting involved, and that's what we need to change. It can still be difficult to navigate the industry as a man. A lot of content is still catered towards women, which is why so many articles have been created recently to teach men how to run their businesses. Here is a list of the top 20 MLM companies that men actually join. The top 20 are Beachbody, Youngevity, Nevetica, Bossette Collection, Zillis, Royalty, Five Links, First Fitness Nutrition, Gano Excel, Pottery, Team National, Motor Club of America, Direct Sellers, The Cocoa Exchange, Power, Amway, Primerica, Legal Shield, World Global Network, and Life Leadership. I will be covering these in future on my channel. There is a difference between MLM companies and direct sales. Sales isn't about using tricks and slick talking to get people to buy. It's rather about really getting to know people so that you can help them. A successful salesperson is also the person who is able to help the most people. And to help as many people, you need a process to do so effectively. Sales can essentially be broken down to a process. No salesperson is better than their process and how well they perform each part. We're going to take a look at the sales process. Number one. Become sufficient enough in the area so that you can give out recommendations. Number two, figure out who needs or wants what you sell. Number three, make a list of people who match this. Number four, get in front of these people. Number five, Be genuinely helpful to them and find out what they need. Number 6. Only present your products if you notice that they have a need for them. Number 7. Always follow up, even if it seems hopeless. Number 8. Make the sale if there's a good fit. And number 9. Make them into satisfied and loyal long-term customers by continually providing value. And this is the sales process. Now, let's take a look at the sales process for multi-level marketing, or what they like to be called, network marketing businesses. Let's compare the differences as we go along. MLMs often go by tips and tricks instead of a real sales process. Here is 7 tips to coach your MLM team and cause explosive growth in your business. Number 1. Understand that not everyone will actually put in the work. In fact, most people will join and then do nothing. Just keep recruiting and focusing on those that do put in the work. Number 2. Lead, don't manage. Instead, lead by example. Hit the next rank to motivate your people to do the same. Number 3. Differentiate your time. Spend more time with the hungry, not the needy. Spend more time with go-getters, the people who prove that they're trying and that they are hungry to succeed. Number 4. Get them to turn a profit by focusing on profit-producing actions. The faster someone gets into profit, the more motivated they'll become and the harder they'll work. Number 5. Where is their biggest hang-up? There are 3 major areas that are most important for profits for MLM success: inviting, follow-up, and closing. Number 6. Allow honesty. Honesty and openness between you and your team is vital. And number 7. Proof is in the pudding. As a coach, you want to make sure that your reps are doing the right things. One way is to get them to document the activities they are doing. And this is just one example of how they will coach their teams in a sales process. Here we have an example of how multi-level marketing businesses teach the team how the business model works. So as you can see, at the very top is the MLM network initiator, and they receive a downstream commission. This, of course, is another name for the upline. Underneath, you see 3 first-level direct sellers. And underneath them, they each have 2 second-level direct sellers. And it will go on and on like this. The difference between this business model and a normal direct sales model, as you might be able to see, is that the arrows go up. Yes, so the money moves up the pyramid shape, or reverse funnel system, and not down. Here we have an example of how they describe to the Huns how network marketing works. You get a lead generation. You locate new customers and clients. They of course tell you to bug friends and family and use social media. Then you do recruiting, adding customers and business partners to your network. Most MLM companies have a loyal customer program, and all heavily depend on recruiting to make money, which is why we say they are actually pyramid schemes with a legal loophole of having a product. And then building and management. Methods for training, motivating, and managing your recruits. As you can see, most of the MLM business model has to do with your training, which mainly involves recruiting, how to train your recruits, and how to stay motivated in your business, and how to motivate everyone else to continue making the top people their money. The MLM business model tries to copy the sales model and make it more personal, tricking everyone into believing that hounding friends and family continuously and constant social media marketing is the proper way to make sales. In fact, several publications have even decided to jump on the bandwagon to teach everyone how to be a good MLM hun or bro. Direct Selling Star is a publication that has been teaching men how to become bro-bots. Direct Selling Star makes these types of claims to trick men into becoming MLM bro-bots. This is the type of jargon that they claim, which we have discovered is a lie. And I quote, "Perhaps the most encouraging thing you'll learn about sales is that Hollywood is just peddling bullshit when it comes to salespeople. In movies like The Wolf of Wall Street, they are portrayed as greedy con men, which has led to people imagining a spammy telemarketer or used car salesman when they think of salespeople. Sure, there will always be Jordan Belfort types in the world, but in the end, they all get caught and exposed. At the end of the day, the most consistently successful salespeople are actually honest, dependable, and helpful to a fault. Too many see sales as a way to enrich ourselves rather than a way to create win-win relationships with other people just like us. In reality, sales done right should be indistinguishable from effective networking. By identifying problems and guiding people to the right solutions, you will not only become a better salesperson, you'll also increase your business network, get more referrals, and become a trusted authority in your industry." End quote. Just like women in the MLM industry, men are manipulated by the same tactics. However, they might be motivated to join the pyramid scheme for different reasons. For example, instead of wanting to be at home to raise their children and work, they may join so they have a second income to be able to better provide financially for their family. Instead of joining because of the community and sisterhood that is formed, they may join because of the status that comes with being involved in owning their own company. Just like women who become Hunbots, men who get involved in MLM businesses are tricked into believing they are the CEOs of their own companies. They are also willing to cut off family and friends who are negative or maybe don't seem like they support them. The issue with men is that many are a lot more pushy when it comes to sales. Men tend to be more confident when it comes to sales than women, and because of that, they may be more inclined to cold message or constantly bug potential customers with little guilt involved. Men tend to care less about feelings than women, no offense, especially though when it comes to business practices. Sorry, but it's true. Therefore, it is fair to say the brobots can become more pushy or even worrisome than the Hunbots. However, there are many ways that men can make money with a side hustle. According to the Federal Trades Commission, 99% of people involved in a MLM business lose money. Therefore, this is not the right way for anyone to make an extra income. There are many resources online you can contact in your city that will help you find employment, including your province's or city's government website. There are also places such as the Job Bank, which can better help you. In fact, you would be better off to pass out resumes door to door or via email in order to find employment than you are joining a MLM business. In fact, they say you have a better chance of making money as a professional gambler than you do joining a MLM business. However, why do men feel the need to join right now? The economy. The way our economy is now, many people are looking for supplemental income. The MLMs depend on this. They know what to say and when to promote in order to reach you. For example, at the moment with COVID-19 occurring, you may notice more and more MLM companies advertising that they are going to help you with your supplemental income if you cannot work at the moment due to the virus. MLMs constantly use epidemics and tragic events to try to pull at our heartstrings and take advantage of the situations to build their downlines. This tactic works on men just the same as it does on women. I believe we need to discuss the involvement of men in multi-level marketing or network marketing far more. We are seeing more and more men joining these businesses. In fact, many of the CEOs for these companies are men. Therefore, I believe the anti-MLM community needs to begin to discuss the issues men face in terms of being manipulated by these companies. We need to stop men from joining, just like we stop women. Another issue men have is being the husband of a Hunbot who has joined. It is extremely hard to go through. When I joined ItWorks, my husband said he felt as though I disrespected him. He didn't want me to join. He was worried we would lose money and I would be entering a cult-like mentality. He was correct, except I was lucky to not lose any money. Running an ItWorks business was not the answer to our money issues or the fact my husband couldn't work due to an injury. I ended up having to get a full-time job out of our home again, and it never helped our situation. If anything, it created some marriage issues for us since he didn't want me to be a part of it, and it took up so much of my time and energy away from my family. That is often how the husbands of Huns feel. This is why you will hear me tell wives to discuss this with their husbands and take their thoughts and feelings into consideration. You don't want to make the same mistake I did. If your husband says they don't want you to start your own business with a MLM, please do listen. There is a very good reason, and he is actually supporting you more than you know. What happens if she ends up joining anyway? Well, men, all you can do as a husband in this situation is be firm about not supporting it. However, do not push too hard. I have seen marriages break up due to MLM businesses. Her fellow Huns may convince her that you don't have her best interest in mind and you are being an unsupportive husband. You do not want this mentality entering her mind or your marriage or relationship. It will just create emotional issues and resentment. Maybe ask her to watch this video or other anti-MLM videos. Try to discuss the manipulation tactics with her and continue to be a loving, supportive husband the best you can without supporting the business. Being a man in a MLM business may seem like a good idea, possibly for a young, single man who wants to hang out with the ladies. However, going broke is never worth being a player. Also, being a robot is just as embarrassing as being a Hunbot. Please do remember to not let these manipulation tactics get you. Just because you are a male doesn't mean you are above them. Just because you are a male doesn't mean that you won't fall for these tactics. Just because you are a male doesn't mean you will be more successful either. So, remember, don't get manipulated by a Hunbot or a Brobot. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son.
Going to get started. One of the big things, so everybody knows kind of how I feel, my perception when it comes to the marketing aspect, because guys, this is network marketing. We are marketing, okay? Very plain and simple. There's a lot of different ways that you can work your business. There's a lot of different ways that you can work your business. All different types. You know, you've got social media, you've got belly to belly, you've got house parties, you've got, and then even to take it a step further, you do have different methods as far as with, attraction marketing. You do have different methods as far as with cold messaging. You do have different methods as far as with, there's all kinds of different methods. Branding, you've got.
I want you to drop a 3 in your comments. If you scroll through your newsfeed right now and you're seeing anything negative, I want you to drop a 3 in your comments. And then I want you to understand, go back and unfriend these people. Guys, it's your Facebook. And like, it's just like one of those things. Like, if you wouldn't hang out or you wouldn't see this person in life you wouldn't want to surround yourself. Why are you friends with them on Facebook? Unfollow them, unfriend them. Same thing on Instagram. If you got people, if you're going through your newsfeed and you're seeing the gossip from the club this weekend, or if you're seeing some kind of controversy, man, unfriend, unfollow. You don't need those people in your life. Surround yourself with positivity, and guess what? Law of attraction. You will attract positive people into your circle. Change your circle, change your life. I'm telling you guys that.
Everything they're doing right now today, and learn as much about it as they could. There's 1.5 billion users on the internet right now.
I'll place four of them. And then the fourth of a quadrant is the I, and I stands for investor. People that said, go for it. You can do it. Don't worry about it. We'll cover you.
A bunch of Texans come through the country and on the way to Sun Valley.
Business of their own. Owning your own business is a chance to change your life. And if you can change your life, you can change the world.
What happens to us from this day forward? Well, it's up to us, isn't it? Right? And as we look forward, Steve and I, and I know all of you together believe, we are just getting started.